वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट, दिस वीडियो क्लिप इज प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर मास ट्रांसफर सब्जेक्ट एंड टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन ड्राइंग इन दैट फॉलोइंग रेट पीरियड एंड टोटल टाइम ऑफ ड्राइंग हाउ टू कैलकुलेट वी कैन सी इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड्स. सो previous lecture we have already calculated the time required for constant rate period, that means for this period. Then today's lecture I will discuss about how to calculate the time required for following rate period. So this is the following rate period. CE is nothing but the following rate period, and for this period we will calculate the time required. So let x1 be the initial moisture content and x2 be the final moisture content such that x1 x2 is less than xc. That means x1 may be here and x2 may be here. So for that we have to write the formula. And x star is the equilibrium moisture content, that means limiting moisture content is known as x star. So this is the x star, this value represent the x star. So this is the equilibrium moisture content. So the formula is T is equal to W dash into xc minus x star, where we already know that xc is nothing but the critical moisture content, rc into a multiplied by ln into square bracket x1 minus x star divided by x2 minus x star. So in this formula, T is the time for drying, W dash is the weight of dry material, x is the critical moisture content, x star is the equilibrium moisture content, RC is the rate of drying period, A is the area, and x1 and x2 is the initial and final moisture content. So you can use the formula number 12.12 for the calculation of the T. Then similarly, if the drying material or is taking place from moisture content xc to the final moisture content x2 such that x2 is less than xc, then the entire drying period, following rate period, is given as TF. So that means we have to start from here. That means instead of here, the moisture content is from here. That means from critical moisture content to somewhere here. So for that purpose, we can use this formula. So here x1 is become xc. So in this formula, this is the actually in previous formula, this is the x1. Then that x1 is become xc and remaining formula is remaining same. So for that purpose, we can use the formula TF is equal to W dash into bracket xc minus x star divided by rc into a into bracket ln xc minus x star divided by x2 minus x star. So 12.13 can be used when you are drying the moisture from critical moisture content to the x2. Then sometimes we want to calculate the total drying period. So for that you have to take the addition of constant rate period and falling rate period. So from this we have to take both the formula, that means previous formula for constant drying period and this formula. And you have to take the constant W dash RCA constant taken out from the outside of the bracket, and then we have to add, first write the remaining part of constant rate period and then add following rate period. So in this way we can calculate the total drying period, which includes TC plus TF. That means from here, here to somewhere here. So this contain both constant rate period and following rate period. So this is known as the total time for drying. Then we will discuss one problem for calculation of total drying period. The slab of paper having area 2 meter square is dried under condition 67% to 30% moisture. The equilibrium moisture is 0.5. If critical moisture is 60% and rate of drying is 1.5 kg per meter square hour, then calculate the drying time. The dry weight of the slab, means paper slab, is having 2.5 kg and all moisture contents are given on a weight basis. So the given is area 2 meter square W dash, that means dry weight of the slab is 2.5 kg. Then if we take the X is the weight fraction of the moisture in the slab on a weight basis, WET weight basis, then you have to calculate the values, different values of X1, X2, XC and X star. So first we calculate the X1, so which is X1 is nothing but it is 67%. So first we have to divide 67 by 100 and then we have to calculate the X1. So this X1 is 0.67 divided by 1 minus 0.67. So we get 2.03 kg moisture per kg dry solid. So in this way we can calculate the another moistures. X2 means final moisture content. So this is 0.428. Similarly, X star is given 5%. So we have to again convert, you know, on dry basis. And critical moisture content XC is 60%. So that is become on a dry basis 1.5. And rate period is given as a 1.5 kg per meter square hour. Then X2 is less than XC. So in the formula, in the given data, X2 is less than XC. Therefore, we can calculate the total drying period. T is equal to TC plus TF. So you have to take this formula, that is total drying period, and you have to take outside this common W dash ARC and you have to put all these value. So we have already a W dash value is given, area is also given and RC is also given, and put the values of X1, XC, X star, then LN, XC, X star and all these things, and calculate the value of total drying time, which is equal to 2.01 hour. So here this time is calculated from here to here, somewhat here. So this is known as the total drying period. Which is equal to 2.01 hour. So similar, there is one example. So you solve this example in your notebook. The solids are dried under constant drying condition from 67% to 25% moisture. The value of equilibrium moisture content is 1%. Critical moisture content is 40% and rate of drying period is 1.5 kg per meter square hour. Calculate the drying time. And the drying surface is 0.5 meter square per kg dry solid. So the hint is given that this is nothing but A divided by W dash value, which is equal to 0.5. So you have to take the inverse of this, which is equal to W dash into A, which is equal to 2. And again, you have to use this formula and calculate the value of total drying period. So solve this example in your notebook. Thank you.